Anglo Pacific's announced this morning they've entered into a conditional agreement with Denison Mines to receive a portion of the toll milling proceeds from the McClean Lake uranium mill in northern Saskatchewan. Well, for all the details, I've got with me in the studio now Anglo's Chief Executive, Julian Treger. Julian, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Thanks for coming in. Very good, thank you. First off, tell me a bit more about what's involved here. What's the deal all about?
Well, it's about expanding our portfolio into a new area like uranium and also into Canada. And what we're doing is investing $43.5 million to buy a 13-year loan that's repayable with a 10% interest rate, plus a stream of income based upon the uranium production thereafter.
This is an already producing asset here, so attractive from that point of view. Why else is it an attractive acquisition for you?
Well, it ticks so many of the boxes that we've been looking for in a deal. We like moving away from coal. It's got a long life. It's rarely blue chip, so it's consistent with our exposure to Rio and BHP Billiton in the rest of the portfolio. It's got some upside. And it's run by a very well-considered management team. So we're very excited about this as a way to move forward.
Importantly, why now? Why have you just chosen now to do this deal?
Well, we've been working on it for some time, actually. But we like getting more exposure to uranium when the uranium price is low. We think it's an appropriate time to get into commodities ahead of the markets taking off. And we think that this will be very attractive and accretive to our earnings for this year. One of the great aspects of the transaction is that the income we get is backdated to the middle of last year. So we will start with quite a large amount of income, which will really help the results for the first half of this year.
And for 2017, they're looking to ramp up production there too, aren't they?
Yes, I think they will ramp up production, and they could ramp up considerably more if the uranium price recovers as we expect over time.
Just touching on that a little bit more, why uranium? Because 2016 wasn't its finest year. Why have you chosen uranium?
Well, I think in mining, you've got to be contrarian to generate good returns. And we think the long-term prospects for uranium continue to be attractive. The Chinese are ramping up quite rapidly the number of reactors they're producing, and there's not a lot of new uranium coming on board. Very interestingly, actually, in the last couple of weeks, the biggest uranium producers, or the swing producers rather, which are the Kazakhs, have started to cut back on their production, and so they're going to be stabilizing the uranium market. So we think this is an opportune time to get in to that sector. On the other hand, our deal is all about a piece of the toll revenues and not directly related to the uranium price. So we have a lot of protection as well on the downside.
A lot of protection there. Do you reckon this deal is going to get a good support from shareholders?
I think so. I think shareholders have been waiting for us to do something which is clearly accretive and which moves the business forward for some time. And I think it's now appropriate and it's a good deal.
Now appropriate, you say. 2017, as we spoke last time, Kestrel, your coal mine there is really going to come into its own. So this is now a good time to diversify, you reckon?
I think it's a good time to diversify, and we've also got a lot of income. So when we're financing this transaction, we're financing it only half with equity. Half is being used from our borrowing facilities, which we'll repay quite quickly with the new income from Kestrel. So I think it's also an appropriate time for us to use the balance sheet in this way.
Let's stick with Kestrel for a moment. 2016 was a good year for coal, and when we spoke on the phone last time, an excellent year for Anglo Pacific. Optimistic, confident going forward for 2017?
Well, even before the benefits of this transaction with Denison, which, as I say, are backdated to the middle of last year, so there's going to be a turbocharging of income in the first half of the year, we were looking at a better year for Anglo Pacific even than in 2016. The main driver of that is the fact that the coal price is still higher than it was last year. Plus, our share of the Kestrel revenues is going to be considerably higher this year than it was last year. So we are very favorably inclined towards the results for this year.
Just remind us what your plans are for the dividend this year.
Well, what we've said, and we said this last week with the trading update, is that we will review the level of dividends during the course of the year, depending upon the trajectory of the coal price and whether income comes in as expected. But obviously, with this additional income from the accretive deal with Denison, there's a higher prospect of the dividend being increased.
Really good to see you again, Julian. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you very much, Andrew.